Thank you so much for being here. This is really exciting to be with you in 30 Rock. We worked together at SNL for 4 years.
It's great to be back. Thanks so much for having
me. Of course. And one of the things I love asking people who worked at SNL was, do you remember any of the sketch of yours that you wrote that didn't make it on the show?
There are too many to count. I was responsible for a lot of failed sketches,
yes.
as you remember.
But great sketches, but definitely ones that the audience did not care for.
That's right. And my favorite of those failures, I wrote with Marika Sawyer and John Mulaney, and it was a parody of the Babysitter's Club. Uh-huh. And in this sketch, a new babysitter joined the club, and she was a 65-year-old Filipino woman. And she had joined the Babysitter's Club not so much to have fun, but more out of financial necessity.
Right.
And she did not get along with the gossiping tweens
right.
in the group.
And I remember, you want to tell everybody who played the 65-year-old Guatemalan lady?
It was Fred Armisen.
Yes, there was.
He did the best he could with the material.
Yeah, yeah. No, absolutely.
Yeah.
You've been incredibly prolific. You're 30 years old, 4 short story collections, 2 novels. What is the biggest difference? What are the advantages, disadvantages between writing fiction and writing sketch comedy for television?
Well, the biggest advantage to writing sketch comedy, especially for a great show like SNL, is you have access to these brilliant, talented actors that will elevate your mediocre material. So, you know, my trick when I was writing for SNL is if I was writing a sketch and the script was going poorly, on page 5, I could say something like, you know, Bill enters.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, it's like a pretty good sketch.
Yeah.
But in a novel, it's harder to do that.
Yeah. You can't really just, in a novel, say Kristen Wiig walks in the door.
Yeah, sometimes you wish you could. But,
yeah.